Illeana very sexy and very funny, and everybody loves her, right? I don't know why. And I thought that would be a good combination. And then you came to the set, and we had no rehearsal. The first time I saw you, you show up in costume with this crazy hairdo, and all I'm thinking, I've never been to film before, and the fucking wardrobe person or the hair and makeup person didn't warn me. And Illeana comes out, and she's got this crazy hairdo, and it's orange, and I'm thinking, holy shit, what the hell is it? She's so dedicated to the role that she dyed her hair. I said, tell her, I don't want to hurt your feelings and say, get rid of that stupid wig, and find out it's not a wig, so I didn't say anything. And then I thought, I'd see, you know, how you perform it, because we never auditioned. I didn't know how you were going to do it. And I thought, oh, this is different than how I liked it, you know? It's sort of goofy. But it was good. You still captured that.
I based the hair on Laurie Anderson.
Nice.
As a New Yorker, were you exercising some demons by making it like a failed video?
Yeah, because I moved to New York around 81, 82, and I just always remember being dragged, you know, downtown to see some horrible, you know, performance art.
That Laurie Anderson did an underground comic book called Baloney Moccasins. Or Baloney
of course Moccasins.
He did. Right.
I used to have
of course he did.
I worked at Last Gasp Publishing Company on 20th and Bryan. It's still there, and I used to have to pack those things and ship them. It was like one of the worst comic books ever. And who was the producer of it? Leo's father, George DiCaprio.
Was he trying to find the money in underground comics? Like,
well, George was himself. He did an underground comic book called Greaser Comics.
Was that okay?
It was much better than Baloney Moccasin.
Was Baloney Moccasin like concurrent with other stabs at art, or?
I don't remember much of it, except it was just awful.
I'm sorry that we even brought it up. It sounds like a traumatic.
That's why she had to have the unitard. The costumer, actually, the fantastic Mary Zoffrey.
Yeah, she's great.
Yeah, she's fantastic. I think all the clothes, my God.
Did you have any input on those clothes? Or did
Oh, yeah, I said her I definitely wanted a unitard. I thought that Roberta still, you know.
That's great. I had zero input on any of the clothes. Except, not for your clothes, anyway. For the Seymour, is everything I wore, she just copied and put it on. And for Enid, I liked what she came up with. Those boots were great. You know, the raptor.
Yes. And will there be a sequel to Mirror Father Mirror? Come on, it's everybody's favorite film.
What about the expanded Ghost World Cinematic Universe?
Blues Hammer actually turned into a real band. Not the same, I don't think the same guys, but some offshoot of them. Sort of like Spinal Tap, where they went around for a little while. And then there was an imitation Blues Hammer. There were like three or four in there.
Was it like the toiling, like, there's like, weren't there like adversarial midget kiss cover bands, like the kind of the smallest midge? Do you guys have any questions?
Where do we begin?
Can't see any of you.
Go for it.
He wrote it with me. He better not have had any. He was a stern taskmaster, Dan. Tough.
What was that like? What was your collaboration like?
I had an office over at an animation studio at 18th and York Street. Forget the name of the animation studio. It's long since out of business. And we literally.